Before flying a regulated drone in Luxembourg, you need to go through a couple of steps. First, get a remote pilot license after completing an online training and certification. Then, get insurance for your drone in case you are not already covered by an existing plan. Lastly, register as a UAS operator to receive your registration number and put this number on your drone. If you are unsure if these steps apply to you, start by doing the online training for the pilot license. This will give you much more information on the topic and should clear things up. It is free of charge and can be done quickly. You can find all links in the description. The goal of the remainder of this video is to provide some additional details to help you get started. Before going into any further detail, it is important to know which drones are actually regulated and therefore require the aforementioned steps. As specified by the EU Regulation 2019/947, the rules apply to unmanned aircraft systems, short UAS, that are heavier than 250 grams or any UAS with sensors that are able to capture personal data. This includes, but is not limited to, drones with cameras and/or microphones. The regulation does not speak about drones in particular, as it is also covering other types of unmanned vehicles that are able to fly, such as remote-controlled airplanes. Anyway, in the context of drones, only light, remote-controlled toys without sensors are excluded from the regulation. Indoor operation is also excluded. Please note that in this video, I'm talking about the situation and procedures particularly in Luxembourg. While the same rules apply across Europe, there's no centralized EU-wide training and registration, and the process seems to be slightly different from one country to another. In Luxembourg, the Direction d'Aviation Civile, short DAC, is in charge of drone regulations, including the organization of the remote pilot trainings and the registration system, which are linked on their website. In my opinion, the training is extremely well made, straightforward and very informative. It took me around 3 hours to complete, as I did some additional research and reading while going through it. At the end, you get the remote pilot license certificate that you should print out and carry with you when you go flying. A key factor that you might want to consider, even before getting a drone, is the class and category system, which determines where and with what you can fly. In a nutshell, you have classes ranging from C0 to C5, in which drones are divided according to their weight. This classification system is required by the EU regulation, but most currently sold drones come unmarked, in which case the owner needs to determine the class by checking the drone's weight. In addition to the class system, 3 open categories called A1, A2 and A3 exist, which describe different scenarios. In this video, I will only talk about the open categories, as they are the only ones accessible after the completion of the online certification and beyond. In this category, you are only allowed to carry out low-risk operations. In particular, in A1, you are allowed to fly close to people and buildings, but not above groups of people. In A2, you can fly within a safe distance to people and buildings, and in A3, you can only fly remotely away from people and buildings. The idea is that light drones are allowed to fly in all categories, while heavy drones are not allowed to fly in the A1 or A2 category. For now, some medium-sized drones are allowed to fly in A2, but only if the remote pilot has finished some extra training and certification first. Please note that this system will be simplified on the 1st of January 2023. After that date, all drones weighing more than 250 grams with sensors able to capture personal data will only be allowed to fly in the A3 category, and everything lighter falls in A1. In my personal opinion, the easiest way forward for most casual drone pilots is probably to stick with a below 250 grams C0 drone if you just want to get started. As mentioned in the beginning, all of this gets covered in detail in the remote pilot training, but it might help knowing that some limitations come with the drone's weight. If you are undecided on buying a drone, or if all of this does not make sense to you, I again recommend simply doing the free online training to get a better understanding before taking a decision. By the way, the training is available in English, German, French and Luxembourgish. An insurance is required to fly your drone, as you learn in the online training as well as the UAS operator registration step. Speaking about Luxembourg, I was unfortunately not able to find much information about the drone specific coverage in general. As a result, I simply called my insurance agent, which added this as an extra option to my already existing liability protection. In my case, this addition will cost me about 50 euros per year and applies to drones up to 5 kilograms as long as they are not flown for commercial use. It is also good to know that my coverage includes RC airplanes and helicopters, which fall under the same EU regulation. Once your coverage is confirmed, you have to use the insurance number during the registration as a UAS operator online through gishi.lu. The registration only takes a couple of minutes and requires some personal data as well as your insurance policy number. This will provide you with a registration certificate that should be printed and kept close to you when you go flying. The process will also provide you with a registration number that you need to attach to your drone in a clearly readable way. In order to know where to fly in Luxembourg, you can check the UAS geographical zones using geoportal.lu. Nonetheless, some places may post signage which forbids flying your drone, which of course you need to respect. As explained in the training, don't ever fly near airports or above 120 meters. Also, always have a visual line of sight when flying. Finally, once all your paperwork is done and you found a suitable place for your very first flight, I have one last bonus tip. Even if it's only slightly sunny outside, take sunglasses and a hat with you. I would like to conclude by saying that I like the current approach of having a free online training and registration, as it raises the bar only slightly and still helps avoid issues in the future. Having a shared regulation across Europe is an additional benefit, as it simplifies a lot of things. I also need to give a short disclaimer, as this video gives a very limited overview. Although it has been produced to the best of my knowledge, errors and mistakes happen. So while this video can serve as an entry point to the topic, I advise viewers to do their own research, beyond what has been presented in this short sum up. That's it, and I thank you for watching.